Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you a couple different ways to validate whether or not a cell in Excel is a certain color. So by the end of this video, we are going to use two different ways to either put the word pass or fail in column B if the color in column A is this greenish color. And to do that, we are going to use the Get.Cell built-in function, and then we're also going to use VBA. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So my first option for evaluating a cell color is to use the Get.Cell function. But the Get.Cell function is different from regular Excel functions that we've used in the past because the Get.Cell function is a built-in function in Excel that retrieves information about the formatting, location, or contents of a cell. However, it cannot be directly referred to in the worksheet. So in order to use Get.Cell, we are going to have to create a named range with the name manager inside of Excel. And so we can access the name manager by going up to formulas and going over here to name manager. And then if I click on new, I can create the function up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call it cell color, all one word. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And down here where it says refers to, I'm going to type equals get.cell with a left parenthesis. And the first argument I pass into the get.cell function is which characteristic do I want to evaluate on a cell? And so in this case, I want to evaluate the background color on a cell. And that code is 38. And there's a lot of different codes you could have entered in here. Like I could be evaluating whether or not there is a top border or a bottom border or various other ways that you have formatted a cell. So if you want a list of those, you can just Google get.cell and the list is out there. So then if I type a comma, I do have to pass one more argument to get.cell. And that is which cell is being evaluated. So in this case, I'm going to type A2. Because A2 over here, which I already have highlighted with the value of 90, that is the cell that I want to get the color. So I'm going to close my parentheses. And I just want you to note up here that this is called cell color. And then I'm going to click OK. And then I'm just going to close this window. So over here now in B2, right next to A2, I can just type equals cell. And you can see that cell color is coming up here with this kind of icon. So I'm just going to type cell color and hit enter. And I can see that I'm being returned with a 36. So if I just click on my cell and see the square right here at the bottom right-hand corner, if I just hold down my left mouse button and drag that all the way to the bottom, I can see that I'm being returned with a 36 every time the cell is this color green, because 36 is the code for that color. And I'm being returned with a 0 anytime the cell is white. So what happens if I go into cell 13 and I go up to home and I change that background color to yellow? Well, you can see that the 36 hasn't changed over here. But if I click at the top again and redrag all the way down, now the 87 is being returned with a color code of 6. And that's because the function is calculated at the moment that I copy the formula in. It does not act exactly the same way a regular Excel function does. So now we could use an if statement to evaluate whether or not this cell is this color green or not. So if it is this color green, let's write pass. And if it's not this color green, let's write fail. So if I click back in B2, right after the equal sign, I'm just going to type the word if with a left parenthesis. And I'm going to say that if the cell color equals 36, and then I'm going to type a comma, I want the word pass to appear. So in double quotes, I'm going to type pass and my double quotes. And then I'm going to type a comma, and if this value is false, then in double quotes, I'm going to type the word fail and end my double quotes and end my parentheses. And then I'm going to hit enter. And if I click on B2 and grab the square in the bottom right-hand corner and drag all the way down, I can see that fail is showing up here, 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 and here. And that is correct because it is showing fail anytime the color of the cell in column A is not that green color. So the second way we could evaluate whether or not the cell in column A is that same green color is by using Visual Basic for Applications. So if you go out to our blog, if you look below, I will include a link to our blog entry in the description on YouTube. And you scroll a little more than halfway down onto step 3, you will see this Visual Basic for Application code. So I'm just going to encourage you to highlight this code, right click and copy it, and then hit Alt Tab and go back to Excel. And then once you're in Excel, if you press Alt F11 on the keyboard, you will be brought to the Visual Basic for Applications environment. And if you go up to Insert and go down here to Module, just go ahead and paste what we have on our blog right here. And because of the way our blog is formatted, you may have to backspace some of these numbers for the lines. Also, for check cell color, for the top one, write pass in double quotes. And for the bottom one, just write fail in double quotes. And then note up here that the name of our function is check cell color. And it's going to take a range argument. So if I close this window and I go back to Excel, if I type equals check cell color, and you can click on that down here, and then the argument that I'm going to pass in is this cell right here. And if I hit enter, I will get a pass. And if I click in here, and then I grab this bottom left-hand corner square and drag all the way down, I can see that the check cell color is returning a pass for anything that is the greenish color and a fail for anything that is white. And if I go down here again to cell 13 and I make this one yellow, and then I drag all the way down again, it will recalculate to include this one as a fail as well. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to the Get.Cell function in Microsoft Excel. Feel free to experiment with this to use other characteristics of the cell that you may want to evaluate. If you would like to go a little bit more in depth with this topic, I'm going to include the link to our blog in the description below on YouTube, so feel free to visit there. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.